We're learning about a very innovative theater group that's reimagining the work of Shakespeare. Thank you very much. The Vermont-based collective is putting women in what they call the rebellious nature of the female voice. I like that. The rebellious nature of the female voice at the center of classic plays like Macbeth. Christina Ruffini has our ticket to the latest show.
Something wicked this way comes.
Sure, it sounds like the Shakespeare you might remember. But this is the Bard on a bar. And in this version, Lady Macbeth, not her murderous husband, steals the spotlight.
And look, a coward!
What do you say to people who think you should leave Shakespeare alone?
He's dead.
Literally, that's what we say.
Emily Thibodeau, Caroline Sandoval, and Caitlin Durkin run a small theater collective performing gender-bending reinterpretations of English class classics.
I think the best thing that we hear after a performance is when someone comes up to us and says, I never understand Shakespeare, but I got this one. Is that your goal?
Yes.
Yes, very much.
What do you mean?
Based in Burlington, Vermont, they call their group the Foul Contending Rebels. And what's in a name? Well, that's Shakespeare, too. A line from the famously unfeminist play, The Taming of the Shrew.
I believe it goes, when she is froward, peevish, sullen, and sour, what is she but a foul contending rebel?
Where is the fate of Cawdor?
Inspiring the rebels to acts of theatrical insurgency.
Because it is in the public domain, we can do a lot more with it. We can make cuts, we can move things around, we can change pronouns, we can be a little bit more free to do what we want to with the text.
Yeah, we can really chew it up and spit it out.
Sex me here!
The goal is to make the works more female-forward.
With direst cruelty!
Like their no-frills production of Hamlet over the summer.
Adieu, Hamlet.
Which gave away the lead's most famous line to his love interest, Ophelia.
To be or not to be.
I think our job as artists is to engage with the material and really making it applicable to our experience and the experience of people around us.
There is, in fact, a long history of gender-swapping soliloquies. Part of the reason is because back in Elizabethan days, women weren't allowed to perform on the stage, so female parts were often underwritten and limited.
They didn't get to say as much as the men.
That would be great!
Tova Wood plays Lady Macbeth in the Rebels reboot.
Lady Macbeth is such an iconic character, but doesn't have that much text.
And doesn't have a first name.
Doesn't have a first name. None of the women in this play have a first name.
And doesn't get to die on stage.
Right.
But in this version, Lady Macbeth has more to say. She gets some of her husband's better lines.
My bones are marrowless.
And an on-stage death scene.
Most sacrilegious murder.
There are other changes too. The play is set in the Roaring Twenties. Banquo, a noble and soon-to-be-murdered general, is played by a woman.
Open, lock.
And the witches, well,
our witches are hot.
Most important.
So it's like bubble, toil, and trouble.
Oh, yeah.
As for whether Shakespeare would have objected to their meddling,
I don't think that he would be interested in sitting down and reading these texts and saying, okay, how can we get this as Elizabethan as possible?
But what would you say to someone who says you can reinterpret it, but like, why do you have to mess with the gender stuff?
They can do their own play.
Yeah.
If we wanted to follow those rules, we wouldn't call ourselves the Foul Contending Rebels.
Yeah.
In other words, to thine own self be true.
Look like the innocent flower.
For CBS Mornings, I'm Christina Ruffini in Burlington, Vermont.